What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to TTB Ravens Media, bringing you Ravens content every single day. If you want to see that daily Ravens content, make sure to hit the subscribe button down below. But, you know, I had an idea for today's video. I was going to talk about the major re-signings that the Ravens had. I thought that they were, you know, pretty important. But then all of a sudden, I'm scrolling on Twitter, and I see Ian Rappaport's notification pop up, and I see that the Raiders are releasing Pro Bowl center Rodney Hudson. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have to talk about this because Rodney Hudson is one of the premier centers in the NFL. A lot of Ravens fans wanted to go after Corey Linsley. I wanted to go after Alex Mack. Alex Mack also isn't signed yet. But Rodney Hudson hitting the open market is going to be huge. And so I figured, you know, I'll talk about the other things, you know, with Joshua on the TTV podcast. But let's get into this right now. What are the odds of the Ravens signing Rodney Hudson? How can they sign him? You know, how much could he potentially cost? All of those things will factor in because obviously the Ravens don't have a ton of money. You look at the cap space and what they have. I believe that they probably only have, I would guess, a maximum of like $4 million a year based on how much that they've, you know, given out to Zeitler, I believe somebody. Thank you to whoever corrected me in the comments saying I was pronouncing it wrong. Zeitler and the other signings that the Ravens have had, they're not going to have a ton of money. Obviously, they have to pay their rookies, which is a major cost, probably $7 to $9 million a year to the cap. So looking at, you know, Rodney Hudson, why would the Ravens even want him? Why would they want him? He's extremely durable to start out. The Ravens have had injury problems at the center position over the last couple of seasons. Last year, it wasn't that bad. It was more an issue of snapping the ball to Lamar Jackson, which seems, you know, so simple to all of us, you know, non-centers. But you look at what he's done. He was a Pro Bowler in 2019. And in the last five seasons, he's missed one game. One game in the last five seasons. At playing at a premier level, and in those five seasons, three times he made it to the Pro Bowl as a center for the Oakland Raiders. He is incredibly reliable, and Field Yates even said that Rodney Hudson is in the conversation for the most reliable offensive lineman in the league. Hudson's about 32 years old, so he's definitely younger than a guy like Alex Mack, who's still available on the open market, and he would just be such a great addition. Actually, in the last 5 years, since 2015, I guess that's 6 years now, 93.6 pass blocking grade for Rodney Hudson. So if you put him next to Zeitler and you have Ronnie Stanley on the left side, you've got three really good offensive linemen. And whatever happens with Orlando Brown, if he's able to, you know, stay in Baltimore, then it's four really, really good offensive linemen. That's unbelievable. I mean, that would be a dream come true. Now, the question of whether or not the Ravens would be able to afford him. Unfortunately, I don't expect the Ravens to be able to afford him. I say this lightly because obviously I'm not an expert on the cap situation. You know, you can do things to negate cap in the first season, whether you backload the deal, have a lot of guarantees, that type of thing. They could technically still bring him in. I did see that the Arizona Cardinals are looking for a center. That's from Ian Rappaport. So the Cardinals could be looking after him. But the benefit of him coming out is almost like it dilutes the center market. And that helps, you know, with Alex Mack's price. It may lower that because I believe the 49ers are looking for a center. The Seahawks are looking for a center. The Ravens, obviously, and the Cardinals. You know, now instead of there being one center in an all-out bidding war, it kind of decreases the price on both of those guys. You know, we saw Corey Linsley get his deal going to the Chargers, so good for him. But that, you know, made it so there was only one, you know, really quality center left. Now there's two, and I would say Rodney Hudson is definitely better than Alex Mack, so he will probably be the more expensive option. But at least it helps dilute the market to maybe potentially bring in Alex Mack. So I said it earlier, not like a huge believer in the idea that the Ravens would be able to bring in Rodney Hudson. I would absolutely love it if it happened because, for one, it would help with the offensive line, obviously. But for two, we wouldn't have to spend a draft pick drafting somebody like a Creed Humphrey or something like that in the first round if we already have a center for the future. So that like completely gets rid of that debacle. So you can just focus on drafting wide receiver and edge rusher, which are the two positions that the Ravens are yet to address in the draft. They've already gone with the right guard or potentially left guard. And if they could bring in Rodney Hudson, it would be a great signing. However, like I said, I'm treading very lightly. But down in the comments down below, let me know what your thoughts on if the Ravens should and could bring in Rodney Hudson. Let me know what your thoughts are so far on Eric DaCosta's kind of free agency. Or I guess it's, you know, the tampering period, the legal tampering period. Free agency hasn't, like, officially started. Can't talk to the players. But let me know what your thoughts are on that. Let me know, you know, all the different players that have been signed. And, you know, the Trust the Bank podcast is coming out in 2 days. So I'll be talking a lot more about the specific signings and really the logistics of them. So it'll be much more in-depth than what I've given so far, because I'm waiting to talk with Joshua about it, because, you know, having two people give their insights is better than one. So thank you all for watching. Hit subscribe to see daily Ravens content, and I'll see all of you again next time.